Hey guys, I just wanted to do a quick report, kind of comparison review of my opinion of the Glock 19, Gen 3, Gen 4, and Gen 5. And let me just get to the review. So we'll start by pulling out the Gen 5. Empty. This is the Gen 3. Empty. And I've got a custom Gen 4. And as far as I know, it's just the paint job, but I could be wrong. And we'll talk about a couple of the things that I've done differently that may or may not be effective in my overall experience. Okay, so we'll just put them in line. For me, it's going to be left to right, Gen 5 to Gen 3. So if we start here, we'll say this is Gen 3. It's pretty much stock. The only thing that I've done to it is upgrade the barrel with a Combat Armory threaded barrel, which is excellent, which you'll see in the targets. It has a textured grip on it, and other than that, it's stock. Then the Gen 4, we see it's the battle-worn flag. I did upgrade the barrel once again to a Combat Armory barrel. It does have different sights, and honestly don't know, it doesn't say on it what they are, but it's a fiber optic up front, and I'll take a picture and show you. We'll add it into the scene. But other than that, the only thing I've done to this one, other than, you know, it's a custom paint job, factory Glock paint job, is upgrade the barrel. And then this is the Gen 5. I got this as a rental gun from the range that I'm at. It had, I think, 12,000 rounds already on it, which is nothing. I mean, it's a lot, but that's the way I like to buy them if I can. You get the discount, and you get somebody else put all those rounds through it and got everything loose and wore in. So you don't have that break-in period, which some people may disagree with in the Glock community, but that's the way I roll. All right, so my overall experience, I like the Gen 4 the best. As far as the shooting, I liked it the best, but I will say there's probably a reason why this felt different. They all had a different feel, every one of them. I had several failure to feeds with this one, like it didn't have enough with the ammo I was using was Federal Black Box 500 count. I got those, when was that, on Black Friday or something, through their special, but it's Federal, or maybe it's CCI. I don't know. I'll have to look that up and correct myself. But anyways, so the spring just seems a little tighter on this one. And I've had this issue before. I even have a video, I think, up on YouTube that shows my first time to the range with this after doing nothing to it, just stock. And I had several of those. But I've noticed that before. So this one likes hotter ammo. Can't really tell you why, but the thing I like about it is it just recoils really nice. I mean, that's all I can say. Is this, I don't know if it has to do with the spring or what. Trigger's great on it, and it recoils really nice. So my follow-up shots are pretty good. Now, I don't think it shot good at the range, or as good. And that could be because it has a brand new barrel on it, and I put the first few rounds through it during this experience, so it hasn't really been broke in, but we can come up with different reasons for that. I'll show you this in a second. Let me finish what I was thinking. My Gen 3 shot the best in every way. The trigger was a little gritty, but it's a Glock trigger. I mean, so you can polish that and make that better. Recoil is okay. I like Gen 3s. I have some Glock 17 Gen 3s, and I like them. And then the Gen 5, it just worked. It was what you'd expect from a Glock. I do like the grip, but honestly, I didn't really feel any difference. It didn't affect the way I was shooting. It felt like a Glock in my hand because it just feels like a Glock. But the, you know, the finger grooves, they don't bother me. I don't mind them. I could go either way, so that doesn't really matter. I was more interested in, you know, when I picked up the Gen 5, as to how is it going to perform at the range, and it did great. I mean, I would put it on the upper part of great, like almost excellent. But, you know, they're all Glocks. They're all going to shoot similar. And if you're a Glock fan, which I am, and, you know, I'm a gun fan, so all of them matter, you'll be happy with any one of these. My overall impression was this one, Gen 4, just felt the best for shooting. Gen 3 was the most accurate. And the Gen 5 is exactly what you'd expect out of a Glock. You know, not terrible, not excellent, but very good. Very good. So I'll show you my targets and I'll explain it. I didn't really mark it with a marker, but we'll try to go through this and see if I can make sense of it. So I'm going to have to put this on pause because I got to remember what I did. I remembered. It was a couple days ago and I haven't been able to get back to this. So we're going to have the Gen 5 here. And ignore these for now. The red dots. We're just going to talk about the big targets. This is the Gen 5, the Gen 4, and the Gen 3 right here. Okay. And then I had a couple bonus shots, which this is a Glock 26, and this is a SIG 365. So far, I'm loving the SIG 365. So this is the 26 and the 365. So the Gen 5, for me, you know, it shot a little... what size is that? It's going to be on right and low. But I was more about grouping, so I just held my spot. You know, I can adjust for that if I need to. The Gen 4 shot pretty good. I had one flyer over here, but if you take that out, it's pretty good. A little bit low. And some to the right. I can't really explain why. Still a good group. And by the way, all of this was done at 7 yards. So I like to shoot at 7 yards. It's 21 feet. You know, that's kind of a standard, I think. Here's where the Gen 3 just tore up the field. It's dead on. And... this was the first time out with this and the barrel combination, even though the barrel used to be on my Gen 4. I put it on my Gen 3, so it's kind of been shot, but just straight in, and I mean, can't complain about that. And so just to tell you, that's 20 rounds each. So 20 rounds each, all of them in the target except the one flyer here, and a couple are just kind of sprawled out over there. But that's the hit zone, so we're okay with that. Since we're talking about it, this is a 26, that's 10 shots. And this is the 365. That was, I believe, 15 shots, because I threw a few extras in there just to make sure it was shooting good, and it did. All right, so these orange dots, just going back to, explaining what was going on, I did try to adjust for them just based off of how they were shooting up here, and this is 10 shots each. So to show you what kind of group I got just by semi-adjusting, 10 shots each at 7 yards. That's the Gen 5. And that's the Gen 4. Had one flyer again. I don't know why I keep doing that. And this is the Gen 3. So with a little bit of practice with each gun, assuming they're not all, crazy, one to the left, one to the right, I can pretty much hit the target. So that's it. Won't make this long, but I'm real happy with all three of my Glock 19s. I'll take any one of them at any time, and if I have a preference, it's going to be the Gen 4. Y'all take care.